Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you about the vagus nerve. It's cranial nerve number 10, and we can say this is the longest cranial nerve. I already explained about the facial nerve, but here I am going to explain you the cranial nerve number 10, vagus. So vagus, we are going to start from the nucleus. This first one, nucleus with red color, I am going to represent. This is a ambiguous, A-M-B-I-G-O-U-S, ambiguous nucleus. This one is ambiguous nucleus. Okay, then this goes through this and this is medulla oblongata, the nucleus located here, and this is magnum, foramen magnum, M-A-G-N-U-M, foramen magnum, and then medulla oblongata, and this nucleus ambiguous with red, see here, this is coming from here, and this give the branch like now, pharyngeal nerve, P-H-A-R-Y-N-G-E-A-R, pharyngeal nerve, pharyngeal nerve. Then this is converted to the plexus, it's known as pharyngeal, P-H-A-R-Y-N-G-E-A-L, pharyngeal plexus, and this pharyngeal plexus divides into the two parts, like it's supplied muscles of pharynx, all muscles of pharynx, pharynx all muscle except stylopharyngeal, stylopharyngeal, why stylopharyngeal, it's supplied by cranial nerve number 9, and it also supply the all muscles of palatine muscles, all palatine muscles except here is tensor palatine, tensor palatine, this is supplied by which hearing. Okay my dear friends, now see another branch of this ambiguous nucleus, this is motor fiber here. We can say motor fibers. First branch is pharyngeal, then pharyngeal plexus, then muscle, it supply pharyngeal muscle except stylopharyngeal, it supply all muscles of palatine except the tensor palatine, which is supplied by viscera. Another branch here, we can say superior, S-U-P-E-R-I-O-R, superior laryngeal, laryngeal nerve, superior laryngeal nerve, it divide into two part, internal laryngeal nerve, and another one is external laryngeal nerve, external laryngeal nerve, this external laryngeal nerve supplies the cricothyroid muscle, cricothyroid muscle, I'm going to represent here with M, cricothyroid muscle. Then another, this internal laryngeal nerve, it supply the upper half of larynx, and we can say like epiglottis, it supply. Another one we can say here, it supply the taste, responsible for taste also, but not by this taste for solitaries, I'm going to explain the later taste also. And now the another branch will also, this red one, see this red one is first part pharyngeal nerve, then its branches, then superior laryngeal nerve, internal laryngeal nerve, which upper one half upper half of larynx, epiglottis, and for responsible for taste. And we can say this is for posterior part of tongue supply. And external laryngeal nerve is cricothyroid muscle. And then third one branch, we can say recurrent, R-E-C-U-R-R-E-N-T, recurrent laryngeal nerve. What happens here, recurrent laryngeal nerve, it supply all muscle of larynx, all laryngeal muscles except we can say this muscle, cricothyroid, because this is supplied by external laryngeal nerve. Okay, then we are going to talk about the another nucleus, this green one, see this nucleus, we can say spinal, trigeminal nucleus. Okay, nucleus spinal trigeminal, so let's see with green. From internal laryngeal nerve, it supplies see from here, here, from the foramen. This is known as jugular foramen. See, from internal laryngeal nerve supply from here, from jugular foramen, and it supply the nucleus, spinal trigeminal. Another branch here we can say recurrent laryngeal nerve, also see going reverse back from jugular foramen, it enters to and supply to the nucleus of trigeminal. Okay, then third nucleus we are going to talk about like this nucleus, this third one nucleus we see solitarius, we can say this solitarius nucleus is supply for taste. See, I already written here taste, posterior part of tongue, internal laryngeal nerve, it supply from black sea from here, from jugular foramen, it enters here again through the branches, and the solitarius responsible for the taste. Okay, our final nucleus here, this one we can say this is parasympathetic nucleus. This parasympathetic nucleus I'm going to draw from this way. It supplied two branches. We can say parasympathetic nucleus like superior cervical cardiac nerve and inferior cervical cardiac nerve. This is responsible for what? Inhibition of heart rate. It decreases, causes the bradycardia due to this. And what else I want to explain here? I already explained about the spinal trigeminal nucleus to now supply like internal laryngeal nerve from green this way, and recurrent laryngeal nerve, but two nerve supply also from this spinal trigeminal. It's meningeal nerve, or we can say meningeal branches in head above the jugular foramen. And the last one, and this from this nerve, it's we can say auricular nerve, we can say external auditory meatus. Okay, my dear friends, so now I am going to put a numbering here, what kind of nucleus we discuss about, like ambiguous nucleus we already discussed, like nucleus spinal trigeminal we discussed, solitarius nucleus we discussed, parasympathetic nucleus we already discussed here. So I'm going to repeat again. See, this is the first branch. If we see, this is the meningeal one nerve is first branch. Second branch we can say here it's auricular branch, and third branch it's pharyngeal branch, fourth branch is superior laryngeal nerve, fifth branch is recurrent laryngeal nerve. It's my criteria, so I'm going to repeat it again. So my dear friends, myself Dr. Hemant, again I'm going to explain you in a very easy way. So do together with me revision here. Let's start from here. Nucleus ambiguous. Then nucleus ambiguous, this red line going to continue from here. Then jugular foramen. This round is jugular foramen. Then it divides into first branch is pharyngeal nerve. Then pharyngeal nerve converts into pharyngeal plexus. Then pharyngeal supplies the muscles of all muscles of pharynx except stylopharyngeal, which is supplied by ninth cranial nerve. Then all muscles of palatine is supplied, but except tensor palatine muscle, which is supplied by viscerae. Then the third branch we can see here, second branch, superior laryngeal nerve. This is motor fiber. Superior laryngeal nerve divided into two parts, internal laryngeal nerve, external laryngeal nerve. External laryngeal nerve supply the cricothyroid muscle only, but internal laryngeal nerve is supply upper half of larynx, epiglottis, responsible for taste of the posterior part of a tongue. And the third branch, if we see recurrent laryngeal nerve, it's all laryngeal muscles, it supply all laryngeal muscle except cricothyroid, because that is supplied by external laryngeal nerve. Then we talk about second nucleus spinal trigeminal. It's green this branch, first one is meningeal from the head branch, and then second one branch is auricular, then it's supply from internal laryngeal also, through this nucleus, spinal trigeminal, and also recurrent supplies here reverse way. Then we talk about the solitarius nucleus. Solitarius nucleus, this black one line, it's take sensation, taste sensation from the posterior of tongue, reverse back from the jugular foramen and then to the solitarius nucleus. And finally, we already talk about the parasympathetic nucleus. Parasympathetic nucleus with black line C from here. It includes the superior cervical cardiac nerve, inferior cervical cardiac branch, and this are responsible for inhibition of heart rate. So, my dear friends, vagus nerve work on what? On the thorax, neck, GI system, and on the cardiac system. Cardiac system, it inhibits the cardiac system stimulations, and right laryngeal nerve work on a thorax, and the left laryngeal nerve works on a neck. So, my dear friends, I hope you have clear about this vagus nerve topic. I might aim to explain you and make this video very easy for you to learn it. So if you have any queries, any question, you can ask me. I am ready. If you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. And if you like, put like on it and see that bell there and put click on that bell for new updates and new video. If you want to study any new video, you can ask me. Thank you. Thank you. And